Hello everyone, this is Big Mama Sag from Fire Sign Tarot. It's been a long day. I'm not gonna lie, I'm exhausted, but I'm gonna do my best for you today. Aries, it is your turn. Finally. Bless you for your patience. I know it's not your strong suit. Not to put you on blast, but you're some of the most impatient people I know. Just saying. Okay, here we go. This reading is not going to resonate with every Aries on the planet. If it resonates with you and you can take a message out of it, be it your will, do so. If it does not resonate with you, it was not your reading and it was not your message, so we'll try again next time. Okay. Heavenly Father, Mother Earth, Holy Spirit, Spirit Guides, and Archangels, I ask for messages for Aries. Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus, May 16th to the 31st. Heavenly Father, Mother Earth, Holy Spirit, Spirit Guides, and Archangels, May 16th to the 31st. One more. Wheel of Fortune. End of the cycle. Represents all the fixed zodiacs. So, Taurus, Scorpio, Leo, Virgo. No, not Virgo. Aquarius. Sorry, I had to look at the cheater board. Jupiter. So, Sagittarius. Wow. We'll see how it plays out. King of Cups. Four of Pentacles. The Moon for your energy. Knight of Wands, Ten of Swords, Nine of Swords for the person you're dealing with, Shared Energy Death, Eight of Wands, Knight of Pentacles. Page of Cups at the bottom of the deck. So, messages of love, end of a karmic cycle, King of Cups. Love. You have deep love for the person on the other side of this equation. Four of Pentacles. You're holding on to something. The Moon. Could be lies and deception. Could be secrets. Can also represent seeing things in a new light or from a different perspective. Because things never quite look the same in the moonlight as they do in the sunshine, do they? The person you're dealing with, person on the other side of the equation. Knight of Wands. I hate using this phrase. They're the playboy of the tarot. In and out all the time. Never sure what they really want. It's fire energy. Possibly Aries, you could relate. Ten of Swords. Painful ending to a cycle. Nine of Swords. Being kept up at night. Consumed by your thoughts. It's the monster under the bed or in the closet. It's not very restful, is it? No. Your shared energy, death, change, metamorphosis. Eight of Wands speaks of communication, moving on or moving forward. We'll see how it plays out with the clarification. The Knight of Pentacles. Slow movement. Earth energy. Easy, slow movement. Heavenly Father, Mother Earth, Holy Spirit, Spirit Guides, and Archangels, I ask for clarity for Aries, Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus, May 16th to the 31st. Card doesn't want to shuffle in. Ten of Swords. Painful ending to a cycle. Painful end to a cycle with a karmic connection. Where there's still love. Aries, your energy. Clarify. King of Cups. What's this King of Cups about, universe? Ace of Swords. New start, new communication. Seven of Pentacles. Patience. Having patience. Three of Swords. Heartbreak. I'm sure this was heartbreaking. Five of Swords. Who's arguing? Conflict. Hanged Man. Seeing things from a new perspective. Or accepting one's fate. Wheel of Fortune. End of a karmic cycle. Nine of Cups. She looks happy. That's the outward appearance. She definitely looks happy. She's got a smile on her face, but I think anybody with nine drinks lined up on a bar would have a smile on their face. I know I would if I still drank. She's hiding something. I think she's hiding how she really feels. He, she, it's all general pronouns. This is Four of Pentacles about. Star card. Card of Aquarius. Wish fulfillment. Judgment. Resurrection. Binding soulmate connection. Toxic, possibly. Addictive. Could be a Capricorn energy. Oh, Aries, are you trying to resurrect something? Do you feel bound to somebody? Holding on to something? Blessed union. Hierophant. Teacher and his students. A counselor, a friend. And he marries people. Yeah. That's why they call it the Blessed Union card. Seven of Swords. Could be a card of secrets revealed, keeping secrets. It's also the card of making plans. Aries, what are you planning? What are you doing? Moon card, seeing things from a different perspective in a different light. Talks about more secrets. Strength. Taming the beast within. The infinity symbol's up there. Constant round and round. Are we forever trying to tame a beast? It also represents Leo. I can't remember if I mentioned that or not. Knight of Wands. Oh, in and out energy again. Playboy of the tarot. Almost said Zodiac. I'm freaking tired. Fire energy. Five of Wands. More conflict. taming a beast, fiery passion, secrets, conflict, Knight of Cups, but you still love this person. Put your guards up, Nine of Wands. High Priestess, you're using your intuition. That's a good thing. It's not something you typically do, but just saying, it's a good thing. King of Pentacles, stubborn energy. Four of Wands, stability, celebration. Aries, what are you doing? What are you trying to resurrect? Trying to fix something that was broken? That you thought was broken? The person you're dealing with, Knight of Wands, clarified by the Sun. Again, could be a Leo. Person with Leo in their chart. Fire and air over here. Ten of Pentacles. They're fulfilled. Look at this card. See the family up there? Standing on the edge of a cliff. But they're happy. They're fulfilled. Money in the bank, food on the table, the roof over their head, and they're good. Seven of Cups. Maybe not so good, because they're exploring other options. This is also known as the Temptation card. Queen of Swords. She's kind of icy. She's cold. But she speaks truth. She got a mouth on her, too. A lot like me. Three of Cups. Celebration, banter, hanging out with friends, having a good time. Five of Pentacles. We still kind of feel left out in the cold. Two of Swords. They have a decision to make. Just Ten of Swords about. Fool in the upright. I think this person took a leap of faith. Ace of Wands. New start, possibly with a fire sign. Eight of Pentacles. They're concentrating very much on their work. Putting a lot of work into this relationship came after this painful ending. Death card. Change. Metamorphosis. Shedding a skin. For lack of a better analogy, the moth coming out of the cocoon. Six of Swords, they had to move on. Painfully. Empress. The mom of the tarot, right-hand lady to the emperor. The emperor is your card, by the way. Queen of Wands. Fiery, passionate. Knows her worth. Ain't gonna take no shit from nobody. King of Wands. That's a matched pair. Three of Pentacles. I think we all know what two threes means. Third party involved. Doesn't have to be a person, could be a situation. Queen of Pentacles. Stubborn, independent energy. She don't need your pentacles. She's got her own. Four of Swords, laying it to rest. Thinking on it, but laying it to rest. This is Nine of Swords about. Ten of Wands, burdensome ending. King of Cups. King of Cups. Think you're weighing on somebody's mind, Aries. Or vice versa, all things fluid. Maybe they're weighing heavily on your mind. Take it however it resonates. Cross watcher, that's a message for you too. Take it however it resonates. Nine of Pentacles. More of that stubborn independence. I don't need your pentacles. I got plenty of my own. Six of Wands, victory after the battle. Think someone's feeling kind of all uppity right now. All uppity in her head. It's amazing what we use to mask what's really going on inside, isn't it? This is Death Card about Nine of Swords. Somebody being all up in their head, and they thought they were okay, but they weren't. Five of Cups. I think you miss each other and you think about each other a lot. And what we thought was dead, we being a general pronoun, may lead to a Ten of Cups ending. Then there's that tower. Do we want to rebuild the tower? Cross Watcher, you want to rebuild the tower? Aries, you want to rebuild a tower? The card of waiting. I'm not going to ask what you're waiting for. This is Eight of Wands about... An Eight of Wands clarified by an Eight of Wands. You can't get much more clarification than that. Communication. I see communication opening up. And a new start. Doesn't have to be romantic love. Seriously, do I really need to clarify this? Do I really? I don't think I need more clarification on that. I think we got that. Knight of Pentacles. Two of Wands reversed. Knight of Swords. My cards. You know what? I turned my deck upside down. Hold on. I turned it upside down when I picked it back up. There's a decision to be made. There's old Sherlock Holmes again. I mean, truths need to be spoken. Ace of Pentacles, new start, take it slow. Knight of Pentacles, take it slow. Queen of Cups, there's still love there. Bottom of the deck. Four cups. What's in the fourth cup? I'm going to get you some quick advice. Not that I need to. Universe, I need advice for Aries. Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus. May 16th to the 31st. Four cups! What's in the fourth cup? Six of Wands reversed. Knight of Pentacles reversed. King of Pentacles reversed. Six of Pentacles in the upright. The World in reverse. Two of Pentacles reversed. Knight of Wands. Ten of Wands, sorry. More of that brain not wanting to work. Well, I don't think this is over. Whatever this is, it's not over. But you need to make up your mind. Stay and maintain balance. Stay balanced. If you're not balanced, find it fast. Don't be so stubborn. Slow down a little bit, Aries. I know. It's hard, but you got to. Six of Wands, don't celebrate just yet. But this isn't over. That's what we have for you. Oh. And don't forget about the fourth cup. Aries, I'm tired as crap. You end the cycle. I gotta do the bonus reading for Taurus, and I think I'm going to bed early. Know that you are loved. Be blessed, and I will catch you in June.